Hi, I'm Aristoteles Lavandidis from Northeastern University, and this is QueryViz. Logic-based diagrams help users understand complicated SQL queries faster. This project is a joint work with Jiahui Zhang, Professors Cody Dang, Wolfgang Gadebauer, and Mirek Riederwald, all from Northeastern University, and Professor H.V. Jagadish from the University of Michigan. Even though SQL is powerful and ubiquitously used, it is often challenging to read and understand it. Consider the following set of SQL queries over the widely used Sailor Reserves Boat Schema from the Database Management Systems textbook by Gerke and Ramakrishnan, where sailors make a reservation on some day for a boat that has a certain color. These queries find sailors who have not reserved a red boat, sailors who reserved only red boats, and sailors who reserved all red boats respectively. However, even for such simple queries, it takes effort to read and understand them. All three queries share the same sentence structure with the highlighted parts showing their only differences. Extracting such similarities and differences in logic through a quick glance over SQL is difficult. What if there was a way to visualize the underlying logic of an SQL query through a simple diagram for easier interpretation? This is exactly what we propose. In order to aid users in interpreting existing SQL queries more efficiently, we construct a logic-based diagram that more readily exposes the underlying logic of the SQL query. We call our diagrams QueryViz diagrams. The design of our diagrams is not ad hoc, but grounded in visualization best practices. Our diagrams are minimal and provably unambiguous for arbitrary queries up to nesting depth 3. Our study on Amazon Mechanical Turk has shown that participants with minimal training in reading our diagrams were able to correctly interpret SQL queries faster using our diagrams rather than through SQL text alone. Notice that we focus on the problem of interpreting a query after it has already been written, which is very different from the problem of helping a user to compose a query. Understanding a query requires a focus on high-level structure and logic, abstracting away from low-level details. However, for query composition, this is usually not an option, as low-level details and syntax can affect the query semantics and must be presented. To that end, most of the past work in the intersection of visualization and SQL has been focused on query composition tasks. For instance, visual query languages and interactive query builders have been studied extensively, where a user could manipulate visual diagrams to construct their desired query. However, many times such methods do not provide a single view that can be used for effective query interpretation. On the other hand, natural language translations of SQL have gained a lot of traction, allowing for a brief description of a query through natural language. Natural language translations have shown to be effective for conjunctive queries, but cannot handle effectively nested queries. Describing nested queries precisely in English is challenging, and very often natural language translations can become verbose. We believe that the best way to encapsulate the meaning of an SQL query is to capture its logical intent and represent it in a single cohesive diagram. To illustrate this, let's start with the following simple example. Consider this conjunctive query over a previously mentioned Sailor Reserves Boat Schema. In this case, the SQL query selects the sailors that have reserved a red boat. Now let's take a look at the corresponding QueryViz diagram. We construct a pictorial table for each reference table instance in the SQL query. We also add a pictorial table for the select clause. Each table has as rows the set of attributes that were referenced either through a join predicate or selection predicate. For instance, the table boat has rows BID due to the join predicate r.bid equals b.bid and color due to the selection predicate color equals red. Notice that selection predicates are written fully in a row of the table and highlighted in yellow. Join predicates are portrayed by edges between the two attributes. The edge is left unlabeled if it indicates an equi-join as shown here. Otherwise, it is labeled with its respective comparison operator. The QueryViz diagram would read as follows. Select S name from the sailor table such that they have made a reservation for a boat that is colored red. Let's take a look at a slightly more complex nested query. The SQL shown finds sailors who have not reserved a red boat. The QueryViz diagram for this query looks quite similar to the one before, with two major changes. One, the tables reserves and boat are enclosed by a dashed line bounding box which denotes that a not exist logical quantifier is applied to them. And two, the edge between the sailor and reserves is directed to indicate that the join predicate s.sid equals r.sid is between different nesting depths. The Quervis diagram would read as follows. Select S name from the sailor table such that there doesn't exist a reservation of a red boat for that sailor. In other words, we select sailors that have not reserved a red boat. Since we want to expose the underlying logic of an SQL query, we can perform logic transformations to simplify certain logical patterns, such as the common for all pattern that needs to be expressed as a double not exist statement in SQL. For example, consider the following SQL query that selects sailors who reserve only red boats. If we directly express this query in a Quervis diagram, as shown here, it would read as select sailors who do not have a reservation of a boat that is not red. Double negation statements are generally harder to interpret, especially in large SQL queries involving complex logical patterns. Since Quervis diagrams rely on the first order logical representation of the query, we can apply De Morgan's law and convert a double not exist into a for all statement applied on the reserves table. This transformation can also be seen here using the tuple relational calculus form of the query. In Quervis, this transformation is depicted by the double line bounding box, which corresponds to the for all quantifier applied to the enclosed table. Now, the Quervis diagram reads more simply as select sailors where all their reservations are for boats that are red. Exposing the underlying logic of an SQL query is not just useful for improving SQL interpretation. It also helps us to distinguish between logical patterns with the same schema or even across schemas. Let's look at again our previous three queries over the sailor reserves boat schema. Notice how it is hard to pinpoint the logical differences between the SQL queries by looking at the SQL text alone. Our diagrams emphasize the difference between have not reserved a red boat, reserved only red boats, and reserved all red boats patterns. Now, let's apply those three patterns of not, only, and all across two additional schemas. A student takes a class schema and an actor casts in a movie schema. Take a glance at the SQL. And now, at the respective Quervis diagrams. Notice that despite the different schemas, the same logical pattern persists across our diagrams, albeit the different attributes in each table. For instance, the selecting sailors that only reserved red boats query would transform to selecting students that only take classes from the art department, and selecting actors that only casted in movies directed by Hitchcock, for the students and actors schemas respectively. Similarly, the differences and similarities across the patterns is also preserved. To evaluate the effectiveness of our diagrams, we conducted a user study on Amazon Mechanical Turk, a widely used crowdsourcing platform. Our hypothesis, study questions, experimental design, and analysis code were all pre-registered before we even began collecting data, and our complete materials are available on OSF to enable reproducibility and replicability. Our user study was conducted as an online test with 9 questions. We asked participants to choose the best interpretation of a displayed query from 4 multiple choice options. The queries were all based on the widely used Chinook database schema. Each question was presented in one of 3 conditions. Here's an example of one of the 9 questions shown in the both condition, where the SQL query was shown in conjunction with its respective Quervis diagram. In the SQL condition, we only showed the SQL query, and in the Quervis condition, we only showed the Quervis diagram. Our user study was designed as a within-subject study where each participant experienced all 3 conditions. In addition, we adopted a Latting square design, minimizing potential biases in our analysis due to condition ordering effects. We recruited a total of 42 participants, all from the US. All our participants had to pass a separate SQL qualification test of 6 questions that we created to ensure they had a working proficiency with SQL. We hypothesized that participants will be faster and more accurate in the Quervis and both conditions than in the SQL condition. After collecting our data, we calculated the per-participant deltas in time and error for conditions Quervis and both with respect to SQL. Because our time and error data did not follow a normal distribution, we resorted to non-parametric statistical tests. In particular, we used the one-tailed Wilcoxon sine rank test. Our statistical tests were also adjusted for multiple hypothesis testing. In addition to null hypothesis testing, we also performed interval estimation of effect sizes through bias-corrected and accelerated 95% confidence intervals to indicate the range of plausible values for the median time and mean error. Comparing the performance of the participants between the SQL and Querivis conditions, we found that participants were 20% faster with Querivis than with SQL, as seen by the 95% confidence interval of the median per participant delta time of Querivis minus SQL. There is strong evidence that participants were faster with Querivis than with SQL. Participants also made 21% fewer errors with Querivis than with SQL. The 95% confidence interval of the mean per participant delta error of Querivis minus SQL shows that there is some evidence for this claim. When comparing the both condition with SQL, the participants took about the same amount of time as SQL, even though they were provided with more information. Moreover, participants made 17% fewer errors in the both condition than in SQL. We also examined the delta of Querivis minus SQL for time and error on a per participant level. Notice that each bar here corresponds to one participant, and its length and direction the value of the delta. We can see that 71% of users were faster with Querivis than with SQL. In terms of error, 36% of users made fewer errors with Querivis than with SQL, and 38% made the same amount of errors. In this presentation, we have introduced Querivis diagrams as a method to visualize SQL queries and portray their underlying logic. Our user study has shown that participants improved their speed of interpreting SQL queries with only 2 to 3 minutes of tutorial. For more details on the diagram design, diagram construction, unambiguousness proof, and experimental results, please check out our paper and its extended version on OSF.